top stories. Police investigating fatal shooting. SUV goes over embankment at Old Wood Bay Road. And health educator debunks myths about COVID-19 vaccine at information session. The details on these stories and more after the break. Without limits, happy and free. The skin you're in with no apology. The one to seize the day. Grab an LLB. Live, love, be. With LLB. Live, love, be. Live, love, be. Be who you know you can be. Grab an LLB. Live, love, be. Angostura, lemon, lime, and bitters. Live, love, be.
Trustworthy, secure, reliable, and responsive. These are just some of the words customers use to describe their experience with the Bank of Nevis Limited. And after 35 years of delivering excellent customer service and honoring our corporate social responsibilities in the island of Nevis, we are finally coming to St. Kitts. Come and experience why we're not just another option. We are the standard. Bond Strong.
Dr. Blake's General Dentistry and Orthodontics, located on South Independence Square Street in Bastia, is the place to discover that perfect smile you have always dreamt of. With convenient hours to serve you, Dr. Blake's Dental assures the best preventative and restorative care to guarantee the health and beauty of your smile. Call 466-7622 for your appointments.
Hello and welcome to the ZIZ Channel 5 newscast. I'm Carla Berridge. The police are investigating a fatal shooting that occurred Wednesday evening. According to a police report, officers responded to a report of a shooting incident in Newtown sometime after 6 p.m. Upon arrival, they met the motionless body of 24-year-old Leon Philip of Legreet laying on the ground with what appeared to be a gunshot wound to the chest. The circumstances surrounding the incident are being investigated. The district medical officer visited the scene and pronounced him dead. Personnel from the Forensic Services Unit processed the scene and collected pieces of evidence. The police are asking anyone with information about this incident to call 467-1887, 467-1888, 662-3468, the nearest police station, or the crime hotline at 707. Another police investigation is ongoing into a traffic incident that occurred along the Old Wood Bay Road on Wednesday. According to videos circulating on social media, the accident left an SUV mounted on the rock barrier between the road and the sea. Emergency medical technicians were summoned to the scene as one passenger, a minor, was still inside the vehicle. The passenger was safely removed and taken to the hospital. Details surrounding the cause of the accident are unclear at this time, as police investigations are underway. We'll have more details as they become available. The Ministry of Health's COVID-19 information sessions continued on Wednesday in Sandy Point, where health officials sensitized the public on the COVID-19 virus and vaccines. Health educator in the Ministry of Health, Dr. Matthias Ofrey, provided a history of vaccines and debunked any misinformation persons may have had about the virus or vaccine. As it relates to the vaccine, Dr. Ofrey informed that there were no shortcuts taken during the manufacturing process of the vaccines, noting that it went through all the processes to be approved for use.
There was no shortcut whatsoever. It doesn't take 5-10 years to make a vaccine. You can make a vaccine in a month. But it has to go through a trial phase. And after that trial phase, which I must be trying animals, and then a given number of humans, and then from, let's say 20 to 50 something, and then to move to thousands of people. that will be vaccinated, that will be tried.
He said after this trial period, it will then move to regulatory bodies for research to ensure that the vaccine is effective.
Then after that trial phase, it will then be released to regulatory bodies that will also do their further investigation to ensure that the proof you have about your vaccine or your medication is actually factual and true, data proven. And then other bigger regulatory body like the World Health Organization will assess it and then give you authorization or certify it for use.
The information sessions will continue in Tabernacle at the Community Center on Tuesday, April 6th at 6:30 p.m. As the nation's roll-up-to-roll-out vaccination campaign continues, we now take a look at the latest vaccination report. After the break, ECCB launches DCash, the official digital version of the ET dollar, and Easter edition of the AgriNight Market held. Stay with us.
Want to get away? Now you can.
Stop standing in long ATM lines to withdraw cash. Use your national debit or black cards to complete a wide variety of transactions at supermarkets, variety stores, gas stations, pharmacies, and more. Shop online at the most popular websites and stores for quality brands using your national debit or black cards. And take back your time to enjoy all the things that you love to do. Remember, instead of waiting in long ATM lines to withdraw cash, use your national bank cards today.
National Bank, always here.
Here are your Hustlers Value Mart IGA Value Club Blue Tag Specials from March 14th through 28th. Post Honey Bunches of Oats, $9.99. Essential Everyday Pastas, $3.49. Essential Everyday Box Drink, 10-pack, $9.99. Arm & Hammer Laundry Detergent, $24.99. IGA Single Roll Paper Towel, $4.99. Quaker Oatmeal, $10.99. And now introducing our very low weekly value deal. Kingfish Steak, $11.99 per pound. Chicken Leg Quarters, $12.99 per 10-pound bag. Extra Detergent, $18.99. IGA Vegetable Oils, $8.99. Rica Juices, $3.99. Libby's Vienna Sausages, just $1.99. Turkey drumsticks, $1.99 per pound. Shop smart, shop value mart. Sea listo, y haga sus compras aquí a value mart.
Get ready for an exciting year with Flo Broadband and TV connecting you at home. Sign up now and get a free Samsung tablet worth over $900. Up to 100 megabits per second blazing internet will keep everyone on top of everything every day. While Flo TV delivers the best home entertainment with the latest shows on demand in HD plus favorites you can record. Visit your nearest Flo store today to sign up for Flo Broadband and TV and get your free Samsung tablet. Conditions apply.
Welcome back. The Eastern Caribbean Central Bank hosted a regional event on Wednesday to launch DCash, which has been dubbed the official digital version of the ET dollar, referring to the launch as a historic occasion for the Eastern Caribbean Currency Union. Governor of the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank, Timothy Antoine, said the future of the global economy is digital.
The development and rollout of our digital currency is a critical step in the grand project of building out a digital economy in the ECCU. I truly believe that the digital economy is a principal pathway to socioeconomic transformation and shared prosperity.
He said the ECCB regards the payment system as beneficial for the public and it should therefore work for all except illicit actors.
It should work for persons without bank accounts. It should work for small businesses and startups. It should work for female-headed households juggling more bills than money. It should work for farmers and fisher folk. It should work for creatives and our youth. It should work for citizens and residents anywhere in our current union, and for that matter, anywhere in the world.
Governor Antoine said the tagline of DCash, safer, faster, cheaper, sums up its value to the people of the ECCU.
Safer. Unlike physical cash, digital cash cannot be stolen. In the context of the ongoing pandemic, where physical and social distancing are required, DCash offers a contactless method of payment that serves us well in our new normal. Faster. Payments and transfers are near instantaneous. About 3 seconds. Not 3 minutes, not 3 days. Cheaper. For individuals, there is no charge for transacting in DCash because your central bank, the ECCB, has made that upfront investment.
As part of the live online event, live DCash transactions were also demonstrated. DCash has been rolled out in 4 pilot countries, Antigua and Barbuda, Grenada, St. Kitts and Nevis, and St. Lucia. The pilot project will run for 1 year, and in the coming months, no later than September 2021, DCash will be extended to the remaining ECCU member countries of Anguilla, Dominica, Montserrat, and St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Agroprocessors, livestock and crop farmers, and fisherfolk were provided with a platform to offer their products in one place when the Ministry of Agriculture hosted the second Agri-Night Market on Wednesday. More in this report.
The event, which was the Easter edition of the Night Market, began at 5 p.m. and saw the sale of locally grown fruits and vegetables, soups, jams, baked goods, meats, as well as Easter treats including kanki, dumpling and saltfish, and sweet potato pudding. Minister of Agriculture Honorable Alexis Jeffers said the idea of the first hosting of the night market in December came about in efforts to bring stakeholders together to offer an avenue to sell their products while bringing buyers into one area. He said Wednesday's hosting of the event was better than the first.
That was good then. Tonight is even better because we have seen an even larger crowd this evening. As I went around the market here this evening, most persons were speaking glowingly about the event and the amount of sales they've had so far. I want to thank the entire general public for coming out and buying into what we are trying to foster here in the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis, and that is to ensure that we are providing our stakeholders, our crop farmers, our livestock farmers, and also our fisher folks with an avenue through which they can actually connect with the buyers or the persons who would like to patronize them.
The agriculture minister said in the face of the pandemic, it is very important that producers and farmers are given opportunities to sell more.
We know we are going through some challenging times, but in every challenge, you must be able to identify some opportunities. We have found some opportunities whereby we can find a way for our producers to sell more and to provide the local market with more of the local produce that we are able to provide here in the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis.
Minister Jeffers said the Ministry of Agriculture intends to host a night market every quarter. Reporting for ZIZ News, I'm Kala Berridge.
The Public Works Department is continuing their public awareness campaign on the changes that will occur once the new traffic lights are in operation. One such change will be the pedestrian crossing at KFC on the Bay Road being removed. During Wednesday's edition of ZIZ Radio's program On the Road, engineer in the Public Works Department Livingston Pemberton said persons will then have to use the crossings at the lights.
With regards to the crossing at KFC, once the lights again have been commissioned, that crossing will be removed. Okay, because once the lights are in place, you can only cross at the lights because you have pedestrian crossing that you have to use at the lights.
On the Road airs every Wednesday at 8:30 a.m. on ZIZ Radio during the morning show with GQ. The program is also streamed live on ZIZ's YouTube and Facebook pages. The Champs for Charity Foundation has made good on its promise to make donations to persons around the country just in time for Easter. Packaging and delivery of these items began on Wednesday with a brief overview given by Deputy Chair Alistair Williams and will continue into the weekend.
Champs for Charity is all about caring, is all about sharing, and so as we approach Easter, we want to lend some support to those families that are less fortunate, and so we are delivering some food hampers and hoping that it will go a long way in making the holiday period, in making life a little better for some of these families who will be handing out packages to over the next few days.
As the donation is a conjunctive effort between the foundation and Essential Plus Pharmacy, Janelle Casimir, admin and marketing personnel of the pharmacy, expressed her pleasure in assisting the persons and jumping on board.
Of course, from the get-go, we just want to let people know that one of our passions is helping the community. And as a corporate citizens, this is why we jumped in and we're partnering on this venture. So we're very excited about it and we're very eager to ensure that during Easter, families who are needy are going to be assisted. So thank you for having us.
Food items and support were also received from Agriculture Minister Alexis Jeffers and a host of others. Coming up in regional news, staff who protested at Linden Hospital in Guyana receive pay cuts. The details when we come back.
Everything's gotta go. Horse Roads Automotive, everything gotta go. Clearance sale is happening now. All 2018, 2019, and 2020 models gotta go.
Yes.
Come up to Horse Roads Automotive and get $10,000 off select 2020 models.
That's right.
Horse Roads Automotive is making room for 2021 by offering $10,000 off select 2020 models. And that's not all. Come now and get 0% down payment. No payment until May 2021. $500 in free groceries, free servicing for 1 year, free bill of sale, free tinting, free registration, free accessories, and free licensing. Horse Roads Automotive, everything gotta go clearance sale. The biggest clearance sale event of the year. Select 2020 vehicles, price to go. Everything gotta go.
Terms and conditions apply. See store for details.
Back in 2018, I ran into some conflict with the law, which led me to being in a rehabilitation center. While I was there in the beginning, I thought all hope was lost. But then I found myself being engaged in a lot of rehabilitation programs and skill-based activities, making better use of my time, and then I started getting back some hope and began moving forward. Before I got into the rehabilitation center, I had some issues. I used to pray for something better in my life, and something better has come. Maybe not in the best way expected, but my life has changed for the better. In the rehabilitation center, I learned a lot of things that I used in my life today, like barbering and business skills. Today I am looking forward to being an independent barber, using my business skills while I continue to do skills training. We all deserve a chance for change.
Give our children a chance for change through diversion, rehabilitation, and reintegration. This message is brought to you by the USAID OECS Juvenile Justice Reform Project 2, funded by the United States Agency for International Development. For more information, log on to oecs.org/JJRP.
The Eastern Caribbean Central Bank is rolling out dCash, the next step in the evolution of the EC dollar. Use dCash to send and receive money to and from friends and family. Make payments directly from your smart device. Make payments from wherever you are. Download the app from the Google Play or Apple Store and sign up, or visit dcashec.com for more information. The future of the EC dollar is digital. Let's make history together.
To news on the regional scene. The Guyana Public Service Union is condemning the Ministry of Health for embarking on a massive victimization campaign of healthcare staff at the Linden Hospital complex, whose take-home salaries were significantly reduced because of claims that they were absent from duty 2 years ago. Tamika Rodney has the details.
A union representing hundreds of men and women who deliver vital public services in Guyana announced on Wednesday that several healthcare staff who became vocal after vilifying comments were made against them by Chief Executive Officer Rudolph Small of the Linden Hospital complex are being victimized by the government. During a press conference at the Guyana Public Service Union's headquarters at Border Georgetown, First Vice President Don Gardner disclosed that the union is in receipt of dozens of complaints about pay cuts from staff at the hospital.
It has been reported to the union that this illegal action resulted in some staff, which are nurses at the Linden Hospital complex, have received as much as $3,000. As little as $3,000 as a take-home salary for the month of March, after these deductions were made, which was from since 2018.
Describing the move by the ministry as a deliberate attempt to provoke the situation, President of the Union Patrick Yard said that it is also petty and vindictive.
Because the law claims that if you do not take action on any disciplinary matter for a period of 6 months, if there is that lapse, the employer waived the right to do anything after that.
Following a series of protest actions, which began on March 1st for the removal of Small as chief executive officer at the hospital, the union said it tried countless times to engage Minister of Health, Dr. Frank Anthony, all to no avail. A correspondence was later sent to Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Health, Malcolm Watkins, informing him that the union is ready to engage the ministry for a resolution to the impasse. GPSU claims Watkins had advised that the workers cease the industrial action and resume duties for the matter to be dealt with at the level of the Labour Ministry. Gardiner told Nightly News that the union rejected what was proffered by Watkins, and since then the matter has been at a standstill. The union is also agitating for an increase in wages and salaries for public servants who have not received an increase in earnings since January 2019. The union sent correspondences to Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Public Service, Soyinka Grogan, and President Irfan Ali for negotiations to commence for the increases on March 11th and March 16th, 2021, to which no responses were received. GPSU on Wednesday dispatched a reminder to the Permanent Secretary at the Public Service Ministry. Protest actions began in Linden on Monday, March 1st, after Small's comments made during an interview with a regional reporter were made public. He alleged that the nurses were observed signing in to work at the beginning of shifts and leaving to sleep with extramarital lovers. Small, having been dismissed by way of letter on March 1st, was reinstated on March 3rd. Days after his vile comments entered the public domain, he issued two apologies to the nurses at the institution. Tamika Rodney reporting for the HGP Nightly News.
The Royal St. Lucia Police Force is warning persons who have advertised large crowd events for this Easter weekend that they will face the full brunt of the law if they follow through with their plans. Several events have been heavily promoted over the last few days. But apart from coronavirus-related restrictions on mass gatherings, curfew hours have also been extended for the Easter weekend. More in this report.
Thursday, April 1st and Friday, April 2nd will see the curfew starting from 7 p.m. and from 6 p.m. on Saturday, April 3rd. It will begin from 3 p.m. on both Easter Sunday and on Monday. On all days, the curfew will end at 4 a.m. The objective is to curtail high-risk activities that could accelerate the spread of the coronavirus. Based on trends that the lawmen have been observing over the past couple of weeks, the Royal St. Lucia Police Force has issued a warning to persons who are advertising mass crowd events for this weekend that they will be taken to task if they go ahead with their activities.
We realize that some activities have been advertised. It's a warning from the RSLPF that all these activities have to be cancelled. We have not given any permission for any such activity. In fact, we have not received any request for those activities. So just urging persons to cancel those activities or else they will face the law in relation to that. It is an offense or failing to comply with those protocols.
Videos circulating over social media have shown large beach gatherings taking place. Even before the curfew goes into effect, lawmen will be clamping down on such activities.
Picnics are prohibited as persons are permitted, as I said, to go to the beach. Yes, you go to the beach, you could take a family to the beach, you bathe, and that is it. But in terms of picnic, partying, rum drinking, all these things are not permitted on the beach.
Commissioner Daisy reminded liquor establishments that on Friday, the sale of alcohol is prohibited. He reiterated the department's commitment to protect citizens from the spread of COVID-19. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.
Coming up, jab rollout highlights racial disparity in the U.S. International news is next.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy a life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve, we protect, we satisfy. That's NCI.
I took the vaccine because I want the in-person audience experience at Sugar Mass 50.
I took the vaccine because I want to be performing with all my peoples on Ultra Truck this year for Carnival.
I get vaccinated because I want to be on the road for Sugar Mass 50.
The reason I chose to be vaccinated because of my profession as an entertainer was to have a safer boy to Carnival.
I am DJ Flynn and I got vaccinated because I want Sugar Mass 50 to be greater than ever.
I took the vaccine because I miss entertaining thousands of people and I miss hosting my own events. See you at Sugar Mass 50. Boom.
Get vaccinated quickly to turn up Sugar Mass 50.
Welcome back. The pace of COVID-19 vaccinations has picked up dramatically in the U.S., but the equitable distribution of shots has been a challenge. Despite being in the majority, black people in Baltimore are being vaccinated far slower than the white population. Al Jazeera's Heidi Jokashwa reports.
Inside this Baltimore factory brews the viral vector that will train immune systems to neutralize the coronavirus. Truckloads of the ingredient leave the factory operated by Emergent Biosolutions regularly, destined for faraway facilities for further processing into the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, and eventually onto even further away places where arms are waiting. That's despite plenty of people in need of the vaccine much closer to home.
is right here in the neighborhood, but, you know, it's here, but it's not here. To me, it might as well be 1,000 miles away.
Tanya Gross lives just 2 kilometers from the vaccine component factory. She's 56 years old and diabetic, but she says she's getting nowhere in her search for a vaccine.
I'm having a real hard time. I've been calling around to different places that could help me and assist me with it.
In Baltimore City, black residents are being vaccinated at less than half the rate of whites. That is troubling in a city where African Americans are the majority. And as the Johnson & Johnson vaccine began its rollout in early March, Baltimore's mayor made a direct appeal to the drug maker to sell 300,000 doses to the city where it was produced.
When you're talking about a city that has the already before COVID had the health disparities, and COVID just further exacerbated those, in a city that is 60% African American, where people, black people, are dying from COVID and they're making a vaccine, of course people here should be the beneficiary of that. It's that simple to me.
But Baltimore didn't get the extra doses that the mayor requested.
Let's make it easy for you.
Instead, it's had to rely on the federal government to secure the shots, and Scott says the situation is improving.
We've seen an increase in our amount and our allotment, which is all a part of this vaccination plan that we have that's very robust and reaches us and reaches our people wherever we can.
Like here, aboard a mobile vaccine clinic operated by the Baltimore City Health Department and MedStar Health. It's parked outside a community center in a heavily African-American neighborhood. And nurse practitioner Helly McCallum has been busy inoculating people all day.
Coming to them in their neighborhoods is an additional show of faith and trust that if they can't come to us, then we'll bring things to them.
79-year-old Joan Smith, a retired machine operator and cancer survivor, just completed her vaccination.
Go home and call my sister, but she got her second shot and she's in nursing home. So let her know that I had my second shot and I'm doing fine.
Now that both have been vaccinated, a reunion is in order. Heidi Jo Castro, Al Jazeera, Baltimore, Maryland.
Bulgaria's coastal sand dunes are home to rare plants and enjoy protection under Bulgarian and EU environmental protection laws. Yet the landscape is scarred by hundreds of illegal buildings and construction works, causing anger among eco-activists and the general public. They believe the reason for this is the rampant corruption that puts Bulgaria at the bottom of Europe's corruption indexes. Al Jazeera's Bernard Smith reports.
A haven for rare and threatened species, Bulgaria's Black Sea coast is protected from unregulated development by domestic and EU laws. Yet the landscape is scarred by hundreds of illegal buildings.
The simple answer is because of the corruption.
Dimitar Naidenov is a local councillor who's managed to stop, for now, some of the most blatant abuses. This was signed off by the planning directorate as a wall to stop coastal erosion, so no need for a public inquiry. It's clearly much more than that. Its owners now admit it'll be a hotel, but say it will also protect the coastline.
The corruption is spread up in Bulgaria since we joined the European Union. And since the Bulgarian mafia get their hands on the European funds, and the Bulgarian mafia becomes stronger and stronger and have the money needed to bribe up the government employees.
Just in the last 6 years, the EU has sent 10 billion euros in funding to Bulgaria. Bulgaria, along with Hungary and Romania, is at the bottom of Transparency International's European Corruption Perception Index, describing this country as having a systematic problem with corruption. And it says there's little transparency or accountability of government institutions.
People are angry because this is a very highly protected area.
What should be unspoilt coastline is being exploited by those prepared to ignore the law, knowing they're unlikely to be prosecuted.
We cannot build everything. And I think that no concrete is needed here. We should leave some nature to our children.
This private marina was built without permission by a well-connected politician. Access to the beach was also sealed off, even though all beaches in Bulgaria are public property. Only when thousands of people protested last year was the access road reopened.
I find it particularly sad because this is my future and this is my country, and I can't do anything about it apparently, because apparently the law is not enough for these people, and according to them they are above it.
The Environment Ministry told Al Jazeera no one was available to answer our questions about corruption. Over the next 6 years, the EU will give Bulgaria another 29 billion euros to help recover from the coronavirus crisis. Bernard Smith, Al Jazeera, Burgas, Bulgaria.
Up next in sports, football team captain says World Cup withdrawal sends the wrong message, and new executive of Guyana Cricket Board elected. Stay with us.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy a life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve, we protect, we satisfy. That's NCI.
First up in sports, captain of the national football team, Zane Pierre, is hoping that St. Lucia can use the recent withdrawal from the World Cup qualifiers as a learning experience. The crestfallen skipper says it is important that such a dubious fate never befalls St. Lucia again. More in this HTS News report.
The fan favorite sport of football in St. Lucia has kicked up a stir after the announcement that St. Lucia's national football team would not be participating in World Cup qualifiers. Following a player's protest outside the St. Lucia Football Association headquarters on Wednesday, March 24, 2021, president of the SLFA, Lyndon Cooper, sought to clear the air on the withdrawal of the national team.
We have to make policy decisions to improve. Again, what you think you would have done if you were in my place is fine. But we're doing what we think based on an organization to run, not an event.
Despite Cooper's best effort to smooth over the decision with players and coaches, the captain of the national football team, Zane Pierre, remains incredulous.
Some of us will not have another World Cup qualifiers to play. You understand? And you as the president taking that decision on your own to say that we're not good enough, or that's not your call, because we have shown in previous years that we can compete. So how do you take it on your own to say that this year wouldn't be our year or something like that? That's not your call to make. So we're still looking for answers, and we're not happy. To answer your question, we are not happy, and we are not satisfied with the excuses they give.
St. Lucia is the first nation out of 211 countries to withdraw from qualifying for the prestigious 2022 World Cup. The International Federation of Football Association, FIFA, did not announce a reason for the withdrawal, stating, quote, "further details will follow in due course," unquote. According to Pierre, many St. Lucian international footballers were formally contacted by local authorities to participate in the games.
I was in Italy at the time, so I was with my club, and they reached out to foreign players. I got an email from the association themselves saying that congratulations, you have been chosen to represent St. Lucia in the forthcoming World Cup qualifiers that will be held mid-March 2021. So I got an email from them, which was copied, which Mr. Lyndon Cooper and General Secretary was copied in that email sent by Technical Director CESPOD. You understand? So it was a formal selection. So I was with my club, I was training or whatever, but what I can tell you is that no local player was contacted.
Now in the aftermath of the bitter feud, Pierre is on a crusade to ensure a better outcome for future footballers of St. Lucia.
Former West Indies batsman Ram Naresh Sawan has been elected chairman of senior selectors as part of the new executive of the Guyana Cricket Board. The details from ABS's Sharif Sargent.
The Loop reports that the 40-year-old Sawan, who played 87 tests and 181 ODIs for the West Indies, was elected unopposed to the position. Bisundial Singh was elected the new Guyana Cricket Board president, while Ronald Williams was installed as a new secretary, replacing Anand Senasi. Singh is the current president of the Demerara Cricket Board, and reports indicate that he was elected unopposed. Jai Gobind was chosen as treasurer, taking over the reins from Anand Kelladine. The election could have implications for the rescheduled Cricket West Indies annual general meeting on April 11th. The meeting, which was scheduled for Sunday, was adjourned after the representatives of the Barbados Cricket Association and the Guyana Cricket Board failed to show up for the virtual meeting. Up to Monday's Guyana's Cricket Board election, Senasi and Kelladine served as Guyana's representatives on the CWI board. Sharif Sargent, ABS Sports.
And that's it for sports. When we come back, we'll have another look at the stories that made the headlines.
The Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, Dr. The Honorable Timothy Harris, wants to alert the public about fake Facebook and social media accounts that are circulating. These sites may look genuine, but they're not. These fake sites may use the Prime Minister's photo and name, but their only intention is to spread misinformation through false and scandalous information. Some of these pages are scams and will attempt to dupe you out of money. Do not trust them. You can find the real Prime Minister Harris on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram by searching for his official handle, which is at PMHarrisKN. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages that claim to be the Prime Minister's but do not have PMHarrisKN right after the forward slash are fake accounts. These should be reported to the respective social media sites. You can also report fake social media accounts to presssec@gov.kn. That's presssec@gov.kn. Facebook has verified Prime Minister Harris's official page by placing a white check mark inside a blue circle next to the Prime Minister's name, Dr. The Honorable Timothy Harris. This blue circle appears just above at PMHarrisKN. Also, be alert. If the person claiming to be either the Prime Minister or another government official asks you for money through instant messenger, direct message, or any other means, this is a scam and not a real charity. This public service announcement was produced in order to help you be an informed social media user. Protect yourself and help spread the message.
And we're wrapping up with a recap of the top stories. Police investigating fatal shooting. SUV goes over embankment at Oldwood Bay Road. And health educator debunks myths about COVID-19 vaccine at information session. And that's the end of the ZIZ Channel 5 newscast. Thank you for joining us. I'm Calda Berridge. Goodbye.
The Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris, wants to alert the public about fake Facebook.